Leviticus chapter 27. And Yah spoke to Moshe, saying, "Speak to the children of Israel and say to them, when a man separates a vow by your evaluation of lives unto Yah, when your evaluation is of a male from 20 years old up to 60 years old, then your evaluation shall be 50 shekels of silver according to the shekel of the set apart place. If it is a female, then your evaluation shall be 30 shekels. And if from 5 years old up to 20 years old, then your evaluation for a male shall be 20 shekels, and for a female, 10 shekels. And if from a new moon up to 5 years old, then your evaluation for a male shall be 5 shekels of silver, and for a female, your evaluation shall be 3 shekels of silver. And if from 60 years old and above, if it is a male, then your evaluation shall be 15 shekels, and for a female, 10 shekels. If he is too poor to pay your evaluation, then he shall present himself before the priest, and the priest shall set a value for him. According to the ability of him who vowed, the priest shall value him. And if it is a beast of which they bring an offering to Yah, or such given to Yah is set apart, he is not to replace it or exchange it, good for spoiled or spoiled for good. And if he at all exchanges beast for beast, then both it and the one exchange for it is set apart. And if it is any unclean beast of which they do not bring an offering to Yah, then he shall present the beast before the priest. And the priest shall value it, whether it is good or spoiled, according to your evaluation. O priest, so it shall be. But if he indeed redeems it, then he shall add 1/5 to your evaluation. And when a man sets his house apart to be set apart to Yah, then the priest shall value it, whether it is good or spoiled. As the priest values it, so it stands. And if he who sets it apart does redeem his house, then he shall add 1/5 of the silver of your evaluation to it, and it shall be his. And if a man sets apart to Yah a field he owns, then your evaluation shall be according to the seed for it, a homer of barley seed at 50 shekels of silver. If he sets his field apart from the year of your bell according to your evaluation, it stands. But if he sets his field apart after the Yobel, then the priest shall reckon to him the silver due according to the years that remain into the year of Yobel, and it shall be deducted from your evaluation. And if he who sets the field apart ever wishes to redeem it, then he shall add 1/5 of the silver of your evaluation to it, and it shall be his. And if he does not redeem the field, or if he has sold the field to another man, it is no longer redeemed. But the field, when it is released in the Yobel, it is set apart to Yah as a dedicated field to be the possession of the priest. And if a man sets apart to Yah a field which he has bought, which is not the field of his possession, then the priest shall reckon to him the amount of your evaluation up to the year of Yobel, and he shall give your evaluation on that day set apart to Yah. In the year of Yobel, the field returns to him from whom he bought it, to him who is the possession of the land. And all your evaluations are to be according to the shekel of the set-apart place, 20 gerahs to the shekel. However, a firstborn of the beast, which is firstborn to Yah, no man sets it apart. Whether bull or sheep, it belongs to Yah. And if among the unclean beasts, then he shall ransom it according to your evaluation, and shall add 1/5 to it. And if it is not redeemed, then it shall be sold according to your evaluation. However, whatever a man lays under ban for Yah, of all that he has, man, beast, or field of his possession, is not sold or redeemed. Whatever is laid under ban is most set apart to Yah. No one under the ban among men is ransomed shall be certainly be put to death. And all the tithe of the land, of the seed of the land, or of the fruit of the tree belongs to Yah, it is set apart to Yah. If a man indeed redeems any of his tithes, he adds 1/5 to it. and the entire tithe of the herd and of the flock, all that passes under the rod, the tenth one, is set apart to Yah. He does not inquire whether it is good or spoiled, nor does he exchange it. And if he exchanges it at all, then both it and the one exchanged for it are set apart. It is not redeemed. These are the commands which Yah commanded Moshe for the children of Israel on Mount Sinai.